Hi folks, welcome back to From the Pages. This time I'm going to try something out a little bit different here and do a shorter, non-spoiler filled review, having just recently seen Iron Man 3. While most of the Marvel Studio films have been well regarded by and large, but Iron Man 2 is often given a pretty hard time, and not without reason. Serving mostly as a bridge between the first Iron Man movie and the rest of the Avengers universe, it seemed to put as much or more emphasis on setting things up like S.H.I.E.L.D. and the Black Widow than trying to tell its own story. While I'm not as harsh on the second movie as others, it's certainly the weakest of the six Phase 1 films. But now, with Iron Man 3, would Marvel repeat its mistakes or make new ones with Shane Black replacing Iron Man 1 and 2 director Jon Favreau?
The answer? An unequivocal no.
Iron Man 3 delivers in both terms of story and action. Well, I don't want to give too much of the story away, but the events spiral out after Tony Stark's friend and former bodyguard, Happy Hogan, in a somewhat surprising return from Jon Favreau in front of the camera, is caught in an explosion tied to the mysterious man known only as the Mandarin. Tony declares war on the terrorists, and the two come to blows. The story twists and turns from there, and I can't really say too much without spoiling some genuine surprises. If you've only seen trailers of the film, you're quite likely to find the plot to go in unexpected ways. Which is a bit ironic, as I thought they revealed too much already in the trailers when you see the army of Iron Man suits appearing, but while that's awesome, I promise you, you haven't seen anything yet. Robert Downey Jr. continues to rock as Tony Stark, and by this point he's got the character so down I think he could sleepwalk through the role, but still manages to give his A-game. Gwyneth Paltrow as Pepper Potts and Don Cheadle as Rhodey probably have a bit less screen time than the previous films, but feel like they're better used here. Pepper and Tony's relationship continues to evolve, but manages to avoid the usual, we've got them together and now we must break them apart drama that a lot of ongoing stories resort to. While Rhodey gets some great moments, I'm somewhat disappointed that we don't get to see more of the Iron Patriot armor that replaced the War Machine suit from the last film. It's often on screen, but doesn't get to show off its tech as much as War Machine did in Iron Man 2. But both Pepper and Rhodey get plenty of action as well, so I think it mostly balances out. The villains are fantastic also. Guy Pearce plays Adrian Killian, a scientist working for the Advanced Idea Mechanics, or AIM, and he delivers just the right mix of slimy and charismatic. Ben Kingsley plays the Mandarin, and, well, I can't talk too much about it. I will say it's a pretty dramatic departure from the comic book Mandarin, but to be honest, despite being Iron Man's arch-nemesis in the comics, he's never been a favorite of mine. He started off as a stereotypical inscrutable yellow threat type villain in the spirit of Fu Manchu, and by the time that became politically incorrect, they had no idea what to do with the character. But Kingsley plays the roles fantastically, and I imagine that it'll be very memorable for most people. Shane Black does a great job filling Favreau's shoes as director. Black and Downey have worked together before in the film Kiss Kiss Bang Bang, and they clearly work well together. The action scenes are bigger, but not at the sacrifice of story or characters. While the action is never quite as epic as the Avengers battle for New York, it certainly tops the rest of the Marvel Cinematic Universe films easily. If I were to give Black one complaint, it's that while the music score is solid, we never get any AC/DC or Black Sabbath or any other kind of rock music that has become a bit of a signature of Tony Stark over the two Iron Man films and even Avengers. I mean, he dances to some Christmas music for crying out loud.
There are a few minor plot holes, but it's all stuff that won't occur to you until after you've left the theater. It's not going to hurt your enjoyment, and the ride is more than worth it. As such, I'm giving it a 9 out of 10. If you're afraid of watching this film because of the disappointing Iron Man 2, you need not fear. This film is as good or slightly below the original Iron Man. So go watch it, stick through the credits, and remember, I'll see you on the next From the Pages. Geek Vision.